In his book on Los Angeles' famous Laurel Canyon neighborhood, Michael Walker tells of the time, and just imagine anything like this happening today, when everyone in the neighborhood opened their windows and, as planned, began playing the Beatles' Let It Be at exactly the same moment. This is just one of many examples of the kind of harmony that the Beatles created with their music in the particularly chaotic period of the 1960s, early 1970s. Social upheaval, racial tensions, political controversies, cultural divisions, a sexual revolution, and protests and demonstrations against the Vietnam War all marked the decade of the 60s. Yet the 60s were also characterized by love-ins and Woodstock, a sense of community and destiny shared by many young members of the baby boom generation, and perhaps most importantly in retrospect, a common musical heritage that began with the revolution that was sparked by the first appearance of the Beatles on the Ed Sullivan Show on February 9th, 1964. No one could have predicted, no one did predict at the time just how enormously popular and successful the Beatles were going to be, despite their obvious prodigious talents and infectious personalities, and despite the 74 million people who watched them on the Ed Sullivan Show that night, at the time the largest television audience in history, but what I was going to suggest is that perhaps what made them so successful was the chaotic nature of the period in which they thrived. Even the Beatles themselves, when asked how long they thought they were going to last, said they hoped to last maybe a couple more years, while Ringo Starr famously said that he just hoped to make enough money to open up a couple of hair salons. So maybe, like I said, the Beatles became successful not just as a popular musical group, but as one of the greatest cultural phenomena of all times because of the chaotic nature of this period, a period of such radical change and controversy that the culture needed some kind of unifying force to hold it together. Chaos theory, in short, suggests that nature has a tendency to break down or devolve into chaos, but that this very chaos and apparent randomness has the ability to produce patterns and similarities among diverse phenomena that are capable of creating amazing beauty and harmony. The Beatles were great songwriters, and their early love songs and ballads have stood the test of time as great pop music compositions. But it was the way in which the Beatles responded to the chaos of their times that catapulted them into the cultural stratosphere. In other words, the Beatles created the music, but the chaos and the culture of the times created the phenomenon that we know as the Beatles. For example, when Beatles fans, many of whom eagerly anticipated the release of their next album or single, brought home Revolver, George Harrison's biting indictment of the Taxman affirmed, or perhaps even initiated, their anti-establishment views. When they heard the Beatles introduce themselves as Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band on the album of the same title, they joined them in an escapist fantasy that many young people found so appealing at the time. The Beatles influenced and reflected the hippie ideal in songs such as All You Need Is Love, a live performance of which was broadcast via satellite to an estimated 300 million people in the summer of 1967. In short, the Beatles influenced the culture and reflected it back to itself, much in the same way that in chaos theory, the universe responds to endless and unpredictable feedback mechanisms. Thus, the Beatles as a group began to fray just at the same time that divisions were beginning to emerge within the youth culture in the particularly chaotic year of 1968, while the Beatles responded to the chaos caused by revolutions and assassinations that year with songs such as Revolution and Happiness is a Warm Gun. Then, just as the 60s were ending, the Beatles too ended and left the realm of history to enter the realm of spiritual enlightenment by singing at the end of their song, The End, on Abbey Road, that the love you take is equal to the love you make, an equation of perfect harmony in the midst of chaos. So what does this mean for us? Will our own chaotic and divided times produce some kind of unifying force to hold our own fractured culture together? Perhaps it is too much to hope that our times will produce another Beatles, although, if chaos theory is correct, that's not totally out of the question, and maybe that's something you might want to look out for. But perhaps we just still need the Beatles, who left us a musical legacy that might help us cope with our troubled times, just as it did for millions across the globe amidst the chaos of the 1960s. Thank you.